It's been 60 games in the all-time series between UMass Boston and the University of Southern Maine, and every single one has resulted in the same thing, a Southern Maine victory. But today, the Beacons facing off against their Little East Conference opponent, can't quite call them a rival in an 0-60 all-time series, look to make a little bit of history of their own as they try to hand Gary Fifield, the 14-time Little East Conference Coach of the Year, his first ever loss here in Boston. The Beacons have played four consecutive games against the Huskies in single-digit final margin. They're hoping that that could be the impetus to finally get that big victory as they're coming off one of their biggest victories of the year, a 19-point win over Keene State on Sunday, as they try to start off the second half of their Little East Conference schedule with a big W. My name is Seth Dorensky, bringing you both ends of today's Little East Conference doubleheader, and you see it right there. The Beacons 11-6, 4-3 in conference play, tied with Southern Maine at 4-3 in conference action, but Southern Maine having an uncharacteristically poor start to the 2014-15 campaign, just one loss away from the program's sixth 10-loss season in program history. We'll check out the team statistics right now between these two sides. UMass Boston, not only one of the top scoring teams in the conference, but their defense is also amongst the league leaders. The Beacons focusing on that defense all season long, and it's led to a league-best 33.4% field goal percentage defense. The Beacons also one of the best rebounding teams in the league at plus 6.1 in rebounding margin, second only behind Eastern Connecticut State University. Looking at Southern Maine, their numbers are a little bit down from where they were 2 years ago when they finished 27-2 and won their 20th Little East Conference Tournament Championship under Gary Fifield, but still a very strong program, one of the best in the state of Maine and all of New England. Looking at some of the team leaders, and you'll see some of the best bigs in the conference in today's matchup. Grace Geary leads the Beacons at 14.5 points, but she's only barely ahead of her junior teammate, a first-team all-conference player a year ago. Olivia Murphy is fourth in the conference in points per game at 14.1, second in the conference in rebounding at 10.1, and she'll face off against one of the best bigs in the conference, Megan Pelletier, the junior forward out of Winslow, Maine, a former Rookie of the Year in the North Atlantic Conference when she played for Thomas College in her first season. In her past 2 years, she's been phenomenal. She's second in the conference in scoring at 16.2 points per game, third in rebounding at 9.1 rebounds per game, and she's teamed up with Ella Romanos as one of the best 1-2 combinations in the conference down low. Beacons have a pretty good one of their own in Olivia Murphy and Kirsten Morrison. We're going to check out some highlights from last year's game. It was a heartbreaker for the Beacons as they came oh so close to that first ever win against the University of Southern Maine. Beacons falling by just 1 point as their senior captain and now one of their assistant coaches, Andrea Suffredini, missed a free throw with 1 second to go, hit one out of two, and the Beacons fell by just 1 point, one of their three losses against the Huskies from a year ago.
Ogawa, more of a group player, doesn't look for a long shot. Suffredini spots up for a long shot. The team's fourth big is in with Murphy out. Bill Rickenass made it, reached double digits for the first
time.
Shots out for
Michael Jordan.
Top of Morrison, so he's not really a 3-point shooter. He's two attempts all year. Suffredini, nice little move. A bit more space. Kind of a soft man. It's Suffredini, the 3 is up. That time the Beacons had Olivia Murphy, the conference's leading scorer, this time out. Look, it's Nelson. The Suffredini door right instead, she gets off the shoulder. Jordan looking to drive, throws up a field goal. The high shot, no foul. The Beacons have done a great job of getting in front of the 3-point shooter's faces. Nelson swings out, calendar at three, up Parrott. The second from Ogawa to give the Beacons their first lead of the half. No good. Morrison by the rebound.
Teams are still warming up here at the Clark Athletic Center Gymnasium as UMass Boston goes for their fifth win in the past six games. The Beacons have been hot in January. Southern Maine, not so hot. They've lost four of their six games, including four of five at home, to fall under 500 late in January. It's not a normal occurrence for Gary Fifield. The 2005 Women's Basketball Coaches Association Coach of the Year nationally. He's been a tremendous coach. 14 times been named the Little East Conference Coach of the Year. Checking out the all-time series, it's no surprise with such a phenomenal coach that Fifield has had a lot of success as Southern Maine leads 60-0 all-time. Mentioned earlier, though, the Beacons have had four consecutive games where they've kept it to a single-digit margin of defeat. That's very impressive considering in the first 55 matchups, the Beacons managed to do that just five times. A year ago in the Little East Conference quarterfinals, it was Southern Maine, the two seed, earning a 53-45 victory over the Beacons. Rebecca Knight had 15 points for the Huskies. Kirsten Morrison, the lone Beacon to finish in double digits, she had 13 points and seven rebounds. And Kirsten Morrison, who goes by Keeks, is our player to watch right now for UMass Boston. Looking at some of Keeks' numbers, fourth in program history with her 1,140 points. She's been very successful all time against Southern Maine, though. 15 points per game, 8.3 rebounds, and has had a really nice January, shooting over 50%. She's up to the team lead right now in field goal percentage at 48.9%. Struggled a little bit, as she normally does first semester, getting back into basketball shape after another tremendous season with the women's volleyball team. But the six-time All-Conference player and former two-time Little East Conference Rookie of the Year has had a great year, as you see her right now on camera. Keeks standing at over 6 feet tall. She'll look to battle down low with Megan Pelletier and Ella Romanos. And Southern Maine has one more big weapon down low. It's Marissa McMillan, the sophomore forward out of Portland, Maine, a transfer from Kutztown University in Pennsylvania. She's listed at 6'4". Doesn't see a ton of action, just 6 minutes, but she might see a little bit more today against the Beacons' pair of six-footers. Check out the highlights right now from Sunday's big win over Keene State. Beacons had to postpone the game a day because of the first storm that hit New England. Obviously, this past storm, Blizzard Juno, that forced this game to be postponed by 2 days, dumped a little bit more snow on the area, but the Beacons were not cooled down at all by the snowstorm as they earned a 19-point victory over Keene State to move back above 500 in conference play. Back to live action. The Beacons got 18 points in that game from Grace Geary and Olivia Murphy. Murphy actually finished with a huge double-double, 18 points and 18 rebounds to help the Beacons earn the season split with Keene State. They'll look to earn a big victory today against Southern Maine, as UMass Boston will have two tight ones in their next two games. They travel to Rhode Island College and then Eastern Connecticut State, the defending tournament champions and the preseason favorites. So a win today would be vital for the Beacons if they were to earn their first ever Little East Conference home playoff game in the quarterfinals. Check out the starters right now for the University of Southern Maine. It's a senior-laden group, three seniors and two juniors in the lineup. It all starts with Stephanie Gallagher, the senior out of York, Maine, playing her 101st career game, senior captain this year. Very good from behind the three-point line, 41.2% best on the team. Talked about Rebecca Knight earlier. She led the team last year with 15 points in that Little East Conference quarterfinal victory. Former University of Maine player, Division I transfer at 5'10". Taylor Flood, the senior out of Sanford, Maine, leads the team with her 23 steals, making her 17th start in 18 appearances. Megan Pelletier will be calling her name quite a lot tonight, making her 16th start in 17 games, leads the team in points per game and rebounds per game. She's also first on the team with her 46.8% field goal percentage and third on the side, shooting over 70% from the free throw line. Finally, Ella Ramonis, junior forward out of Portland, Maine, a former Barry University transfer. We'll take a commercial break for the national anthem, and then we'll be back with the Beacon starters here on the Beacons Broadcast Network.
Hi, I'm Kirsten.
UMass Boston was my first choice because when I came to the campus, I saw that there was a lot of diversity. There's a lot of people here. There is a lot of international students, so it's really cool to meet people from different countries, different parts of the world. I'm Julia Murphy. I'm from Canton, Massachusetts.
I'm Olivia Murphy. I'm from Canton, Massachusetts.
We're sisters.
We're sisters.
I play volleyball and she plays basketball. Here they have a freshman success community. So each major has their own community that you can join as a freshman, and you take classes with them, you do study groups with them. So it was really helpful getting to know people in your major right away.
So in health exercise sciences, we have an internship at the end, so it's so much better to have like an advisor helping you out, like telling you which classes to choose.
Teams head back to their respective benches as we're about to get the starting lineups on the floor. We've already run through the starting five for Gary Fifield, who's had a tremendous career behind the bench. 27 seasons, 656 and 132, 21 Little East Conference regular season titles, 20 tournament titles under the very successful coach, former National Coach of the Year. We'll check out the starters right now for UMass Boston. A little bit younger, but this side has really found their stride here in January.
I'm Tajay Burston. I'm from Springfield, Massachusetts, and I'm a guard.
Hi, my name is Olivia Murphy. I'm a junior. I'm from Canton, Mass, and I'm a forward.
I'm Mallory Nelson. I'm a sophomore from Topsom, Maine, and I'm a guard.
Grace Geary, freshman guard, Falmouth, Massachusetts.
Hi, I'm Kirsten Keeks Morrison. I'm a senior forward from North Reading, Massachusetts.
See, Southern Maine heading out towards the free throw line. We'll check out the keys to the game right now for this matchup between these two Little East Conference rivals. This is the eighth game in conference out of 14, but these two teams will play both ends of their season series in the second half of the year. And it all starts with don't be intimidated. Talk to the Beacons in their preseason video, and the Beacons were very aware that they had not beaten Southern Maine in their program history, and a big part of that is intimidation. Southern Maine, normally a team that garners some of the top talent out of the state of Maine. Rebecca Knight, a former Division I player. They have a couple of other very successful transfers. You're at home. You know how close you've been the past couple years. Have to come out and really play your game. Minimize the turnovers. The Beacons have struggled when they played some full court presses. Southern Maine a very adept team at throwing the kitchen sink and you finding any kind of defense that'll slow you down. So the Beacons need to be able to get the ball inside to Morrison and Murphy and try to cut down on any turnover troubles. And everyone needs to get involved offensively. The Beacons were so good against Keene State because every player was looking for their own shot. Murphy and Geary both had 18 apiece, but Tajay Burston went above the 10-point mark. Katie Matthew hit a couple of big threes, and the Beacons also got contributions from Kirsten Morrison, who was just shy of a double-double. Looking at today's referees for this Little East Conference contest, Ryan Nunez, Ashley Osinibi, and Deborah Garcia. As UMass Boston in their white home uniforms with blue trim and blue numbers. Southern Maine in the dark blue uniforms with the white numbers and letters and the yellow trim as the Beacons will be going from left to right. It's Murphy winning the tip as she took that one against Megan Pelletier, and the Beacons are on offense to start this one. Southern Maine implementing a man-to-man. Geary immediately looks inside for Murphy, one on four. And Murphy can't make the catch. So talked about needing to minimize the turnovers. And already there's the first one. Gallagher will bring the ball up. And Southern Maine will have to face this Beacons 2-3 defense. Gallagher into the corner for Flood. Flood finds the player at the elbow. That's Romanos. Romanos gets it right back. Looking to go over Morrison. Too strong. Murphy with her first rebound. Second in the conference behind Jill Retrowski out of Eastern Connecticut State. Geary looking for some movement here on the near side. Geary, the four-time Little East Conference Rookie of the Week. Murphy's pass intercepted by Pelletier. Pelletier quickly into the hands of Knight. Knight down low, nice feed. And once again, a bunny is missed, this time out of the hands of Pelletier. So Southern Maine 0-2. The Beacons, pair of turnovers. Neither side able to find the scoreboard early. Burston can't handle the pass, and it's into the hands of Gallagher. So Southern Maine doing a great job defensively. Three turnovers on three possessions. Ball down low for Romanos as it knocked down from behind by Nelson, and it's out of bounds. So four turnovers in the first six possessions, and I'm sure both of these teams will throw away the tape from the opening 1:13 of this one. This game was originally scheduled to be played on Tuesday night, but the big blizzard jumping over 2 feet here in Boston and up to 3 feet in parts of New England forced the postponement. Geary with the big three. It's a little too strong. Into the hands of Romanos, junior out of Portland, Maine, attending Deering High School. Pass down low. Nelson with another steal. Great play from the lone maniac on the Beacons roster. Nelson out of Topsom, Maine. Geary has it picked away. And another steal for Southern Maine. Beacons have yet to get a shot off here in their first five possessions, and Geary taps it away over to Burston. These two teams both coming in at 4-3, tied for third in the conference with Rhode Island College, but neither side able to get anything going offensively. Murphy, the first attempt of the day, and she hits a shot from the high post to give the Beacons an early 2-0 lead. Murphy was an honorable mention All-American as a junior. Been a little bit slower as a junior, rather. Sophomore was when she was an All-American. Rebecca Knight able to answer. Knight, a second-team All-Conference player as a sophomore, the only player on this Southern Maine team to have earned All-Conference honors at any point during her career. Bursted into the hands of Geary. Geary looking for Murphy. Now Nelson will try to find her. Up top, Morrison, free throw line jumper, nothing but net. So the Beacons, too big, step away from the basket and hit back-to-back jumpers. And maybe that'll heat up both of these teams as the opening set of possessions were not very pretty. Into the corner for Knight. Knight finds Romanos. Down low for Pelletier. Avoids Nelson. Can't hit the shot. Ball bouncing around. Nelson into the hands of Murphy. And she'll give it right back to Nelson as a couple of Southern Maine players were trying to swipe it away. Grace Geary has been so good in the month of January. 19 points a game. Down low to Morrison and she finishes. Kirsten Morrison with a quick 4 points. She's averaged 15 for her career against Southern Maine, well above her career average of 11 points per game in over 80 career games. Morrison battling inside with Pelletier, and the Possession arrow will stay with Southern Maine. We're going to get a substitution right now. Jill Madden, a Bay State native, into the game. One of a couple of players out of the state of Massachusetts. Junior guard out of North Andover. Making her 17th appearance, 15.2 minutes a game, 3.2 points per game. Had a career high 10 points last week in a win over Plymouth State. Plymouth State, the only team in the conference yet to have a conference victory. Ball passed out. It's a wide open Madden, and she drains the three. Cuts the deficit to just one. So Madden, just below her season average of 3.2 points per game. So 34% shooter from behind the arc. Nelson into the corner for Geary. Geary bounce pass to Morrison, right back out top. Nelson long, two, nothing but net. UMass Boston has hit three deep jumpers from their players listed as forwards, and Beacon's guards have yet to attempt a shot at this point. Romanos trying to find a backdoor cut, gets it right back into the corner for Knight. Morrison up in the air. Knight goes strong, blocked by Murphy. Olivia Murphy second in the conference to Megan Pelletier in blocks per game at 1.4. And she picks up her first of the night there. 11 seconds left on the shot clock. 15:35 to go here in first half play. Pelletier up top, looks to drive the whole way. Morrison can't make the stop. And Pelletier up and under with the left hand. Cut it back to a one-point game. Tajay Burston, the Goucher College transfer. Over to Geary. Geary looking for Murphy, who wants to pass. Morrison will find her down low off the bottom of the backboard, but she draws the foul. It'll be Jill Madden's first foul, the first foul for either side here. Just under 5 minutes into the action, and Olivia Murphy will head to the line. Murphy's first is up and good. Junior out of Canton, Massachusetts, 70.8% from the free throw line. Good for third best on the Beacon's roster as Katrina Edwards, the Springfield, Massachusetts native, will check in for Morrison, who's had a good opening couple of minutes. Murphy off with the second one, and it's a strong rebound from Pelletier. Edwards, the Beacon's third big in their rotation, that sometimes runs five, sometimes cut short, and only three players will appear in the front court. Pass across for Gallagher. Gallagher immediately met by Geary. Up top, Pelletier looking to drive on Murphy. Blocked by Edwards. Went straight up with it, and Pelletier took the shot nonetheless. So Beacons have two blocks in the opening minutes, and they lead by two. Murphy looking to do the same against Pelletier, and she'll draw the hand check. So Olivia Murphy, back-to-back possessions, draws the foul. This time, it'll be on the floor, and Megan Pelletier has her first foul. Nelson to inbound from underneath the Southern Maine basket. Murphy will back up, elbow line jumper, front rim, and can't get it to fall. Edwards over the back. That's as blatant as you can get, as Rebecca Knight didn't elect to jump on that one, and Edwards went right over the back. Edwards averaging 14.9 minutes per game, 4.5 points, 5.3 rebounds, good for third on the team. She is a player who normally ends up in a little bit of foul trouble. Very aggressive player. Madden looking for her second three, too strong. Rebound loose into the hands of Murphy. Burston thought about pushing it, but no one out ahead, and she'll slow it down. So after a very uncharacteristic start for these two teams, filled with turnovers, it's two teams have settled down, and we've got a little bit more offense here. 6 minutes into half number one. Nine on the shot clock. Bursting over to Geary. Geary looking to go all the way. Pulls up. Six-foot jumper. No good. Murphy taps the rebound up, but Madden's the first player to it. Into the front court. Rebecca Knight with it. Over to Gallagher, who's yet to look for her shot. Knight with a foot on the line, and she gets a long two there to tie it up at nine. Knight fourth on the team with their 9.2 points per game. She's in her second year as a co-captain after spending her freshman season up in Orono, the lone Division I school in the state of Maine. Geary leaves it for Nelson. Nelson looks to go all the way, puts it up, and she's called for the travel. One too many Euro steps. Southern Maine looking for their first lead of the game. Gallagher into the corner for Madden. Madden finds Romanos at the elbow. Into the corner. Gallagher for three. Up. Back rim no good. A couple of bounces. Pop loose. And Burston has the long rebound. Burston coming over to the near side. Over to Geary right up top. Finds Murphy. Murphy into the corner for Nelson. Baseline jumper. High arcing shot. No good. And the rebound into the hands of Pelletier. Gallagher looking to push into the hands of Knight. Knight pulled up. Got Edwards up in the air. Romanos working against Murphy. Great job by Nelson to get a hand in on that pass. And the Beacons have another steal. It's turnover number four on Southern Maine. The Beacons turn it over five times in the opening 3 minutes. Geary into the corner for Burston. Burston around two players. Kicks it out for Geary. Had a three. Passed it up. Goes in off the glass too strong. And the rebound is in the hands of Madden. Madden across for Gallagher in Southern Maine. Will step up. Madden on the wing. Down low. Kick back up for Gallagher. Wide open. Knight on the far side. As Nelson got there in time. Contested J is no good. Pelletier fighting for the offensive board. And another tie-up. Nelson getting her hands in on the ball. And it'll go back to UMass Boston. Grace Geary will take a seat. And Katie Matthew, another freshman on this Beacons roster out of Coventry, Connecticut, will check in. This is the first time that Grace Geary has taken a seat in the past three games. She played all 80 minutes last week in a 1-1 week in conference play for UMass Boston. Averaged 23.5 points per game. Matthew from the corner. Three is up. Side of the rim, no good. Murphy pulls down the board. And Burston will reset. 11:37 to go. The Beacons have led the entire way. Murphy from the elbow, and she gets the fall. And Gary Fifield will call a timeout. So the Beacons, their bigs are shooting pretty well. Their guards have yet to get involved offensively. They'll take an 11-9 lead, and we'll head to a commercial break here on the Beacons Broadcast Network.
I did receive a non-athletic scholarship upon entering school.
I got the presidential scholarship, which was huge for me.
I think there's more opportunities for academic scholarships in Division III.
I did receive academic scholarships. Just being involved on campus, being a leader, all those things combined kind of get me.
One substitution for Southern Maine out of the break. Miranda Nicely, the freshman forward out of Farmington, Maine, in for the first time. She attended Mount Blue High School, where she was a three-time all-conference player, making her 18th appearance. It averages just under 9 minutes a game. Three is up from Madden. Can't hit the triple. She's one for three now, has missed back-to-back threes. And the Beacons will bring it up. For UMass Boston, it's Burston, Matthew, Edwards, Murphy, and Nelson. Matthew over to Burston as the Beacons deal with a 2-3 zone. First time we've seen that out of Southern Maine. Nelson across for Matthew. She's the three-point shooter for the Beacons. Matthew down low. It's Murphy off the glass and good. Murphy's been the hot hand for UMass Boston. She's got seven in the early going. She had 18 points and 18 rebounds. And her first game after her first career scoreless game. Pelletier down low, and she gets it to go. Came in on the weak side and got underneath Murphy to cut it back to a two-point game. She was held scoreless last Tuesday against UMass Dartmouth. Went for 18-18 against Keene State and off to another good start today. Matthew up top for Murphy. She wants it and off the mark there. A little bit too far to the right from the shot from the top of the key. Knight being guarded closely by Burston, gets it right back, looking down low for Pelletier. Double team comes. Knight immediately guarded by Burston. It's Madden with it. Madden across for Knight. Knight is really the lone slasher in this lineup. Off the side of the rim, no good. And Edwards rips down the rebound. Three substitutes waiting to check in for UMass Boston. It's Morrison and Geary. Southern Maine just sent another player to the scorer's table. Edwards looking to find Murphy. Instead, it's Burston for three off the side of the rim. No good. Murphy fights for it, And we'll have a foul on the floor as Murphy was battling with two Southern Maine players. And it'll be Knight's first foul, the third on Southern Maine. Three players will actually check in for Southern Maine as Romanos is back into the game alongside Gretchen Anderson, the junior guard out of Kittery Point, Maine. Nicely, Gallagher, and the third player out there is Pelletier just into the game after a short rest. Edwards up top, called for the travel. She moved the pivot foot there, looking to drive by Pelletier. It's a two-point advantage just past the halfway mark of half number one. UMass Boston looking for their first ever victory against Southern Maine. 0-60 all time. But if the trend says anything, the Beacons are getting closer. Madden again from three, a little bit off the mark, too strong. And Nelson controls the rebound. Geary calling out directions. Over to Matthew in front of the Southern Maine bench. Into the corner, Nelson down low for Morrison. Kicks it out for Edwards all the way to the hole off the underside of the rim. Her second one is short. Morrison kicks it out to Geary. Geary looks to drive, puts it up with the right hand and contact. No foul as she and Pelletier collided there up in the air. Courtney Mattingly looking for the foul. The Beacon's sixth-year head coach, who's having one of her best seasons today, couldn't believe the lack of a whistle. Fouls thus far 3-1. The Beacons having the better end thus far. Loose ball into the corner. Gallagher wide open, three, rims in and out. Matthew can't control the rebound, picks it up on the second effort. Geary running 1-on-4, and she'll wisely pull it off this time. Murphy waiting to check back in. She'll likely come in for Edwards. Morrison looking for some help. Over to Geary, into the corner for Matthew. Matthew picks up her dribble, back up to Geary at the top of the key. Five on the shot clock. Geary all the way, draws the foul, can't hit the shot, and she'll head to the line for two free throws after a nice play to split the double team and earn those free throws. Romanos picks up the foul for Southern Maine, so four fouls on the Huskies on four different players. Geary with an immediate free throw as soon as she picked up the pass from the referee. Those are Geary's first points of the day. Freshman out of Falmouth, Massachusetts. Leads the Beacons with their 14.5 points per game. Fourth in the conference. And she has started in each of the Beacons' last 12 games. Has been a difference maker. Pelletier along the block. Great pass into the corner. The three is too strong out of the hands of Gretchen Anderson. Beacons have led most of the way, but haven't been able to extend it past the two-possession game. Matthew long two, front rim no good. Murphy fights for the rebound, can't get the finish on the second chance. Third chance is up and good, and one opportunity. Olivia Murphy with some very good work down low. And she has a chance to go into double figures right here. Just 12 minutes and 33 seconds into the contest. Murphy shooting over 70% from the line. Can't hit the second. And a strong rebound from Knight. Murphy now with 9 points on 4 of 7 shooting. Just 1 of 3 from the line, but she provided some great production along with 8 rebounds. She had a double-double of 10 points and 10 rebounds against Keene State on Sunday. Could very well do the same here in the first half. Geary forces the turnover, running 2-on-1, takes it herself off the mark as Katie Matthew was on the backside. And that time, Geary a little bit too selfish as she couldn't find her freshman teammate who was wide open. Gallagher did a nice job of cutting off any good shooting lane for the freshman point guard. Pass down low for Pelletier, and the Beacons are going to be whistled for a foul. Nelson and Murphy both thought they had the steal. And Pelletier, happy to hear the whistle. Romanos checks in for Knight. So both teams with their starting 4 and 5 out there. Nicolette Kapathanasis has checked in for Southern Maine. Junior out of Westbrook, Maine. Transferred from the University of St. Joseph out of the Great Northeast Athletic Conference. Anderson down low to Pelletier. Anderson shot well off the mark from distance. Morrison trying to avoid the tie-up, gets it out to Geary. And Geary will slow it down with just under 6:30 to play in the first half. Beacon's lead is 6, their largest of the game. Morrison, an ill-advised entry pass. Romanos read it the whole way and came up with a steal. Gallagher being badgered by Grace Geary. Geary taps it away a second time, and Gallagher picks it up in the backcourt. Down to 17 on the shot clock. Nelson will kick it away. And we'll see two Southern Maine players check in. Taylor Flood back in, and for the first time, it's Kayla Stacy, the freshman guard out of Auburn, New Hampshire, an all-state honorable mention player as a sophomore in the state of Maine, making her 18th appearance, 10 minutes per game, 2.6 points, 0.7 rebounds per game, and assists per game. Pass across, Romanos makes the catch in and out of the hands of Nelson, and Romanos makes the Beacons pay as she hits down the baseline, Jay, to cut this to a three-point game. They rule that one a three. Geary swings it over to Matthew, looked for the three, back over to Geary, immediately met by a pair of hands. Back to Matthew, three is up, and it's good. Katie Matthew, the sharpshooter out of Coventry, Connecticut, continues to impress from downtown here in the second half, and she gives the Beacons the six-point lead right back. Flood around Geary, back up top for Romanos, who can't make the catch. To the near side, it's Kapathanasis. Up top, right back to Kapathanasis. She looks for a triple, off the mark. Morrison with another rebound. Morrison gets it over to Geary after Taylor Flood provided a little bit of pressure on the Beacons' senior co-captain out of North Reading, Massachusetts. Matthew over to Nelson, as the Beacons don't normally play Nelson and Matthew at the same time. Murphy rips it away from a pair of Southern Maine players. Nelson long two, rims around and out. And Stacy will look to push. Stacy over to Nicolette Kapathanasis. Over to Pelletier. She's been quiet. Backdoor pass for Romanos, and she gets it to go over Mallory Nelson. Beacons will call their first time out here, leading by 4. 4:37 to go in the half. We'll take a break along with the teams. UMass Boston looking to earn that all-important first ever win against Southern Maine and move into third place in the Little East. UMass Boston women's basketball would love to add a banner up on the side of their home gymnasium. The men's basketball team has a tournament title that came back in the 2005-2006 season under head coach Charlie Titus. He's looking to add his second career tournament title, and this is 39th and final year. He'll be coaching in the second game tonight as the Beacons men's basketball team will host Southern Maine. UMass Boston looking for their second straight win. On the other side, the women's basketball team looking to move to 5-3 and put some pressure on the top teams in the conference. Eastern Connecticut at 6-1, UMass Dartmouth at 5-2. Both of those teams in action. We'll talk about those games. Matthew from the corner, three is too strong. Murphy the rebound right out to Matthew. Passes up on the three this time. Over to Geary and she'll reset. Burston has it, has yet to score today. Matthew thought about the three, into the corner for Geary. Geary right down low for Murphy, kicks it out. Matthew, long two is up, front rim no good. Morrison couldn't find the rebound, and it's a strong rebound from Stacy as she tracked it down. Madden, the three-point shooter, going back and forth with Stacy. Stacy will bring it over to the near side, stripped away by Geary. Geary running two-on-one with Burston. Across for the sophomore. Burston, the left-hand lay-in, no good. Murphy taps it over to Burston, but her foot was still on the baseline, and the Beacons will give it back. Their eighth turnover of the half, but Courtney Mattingly has to love the fact that Murphy ran the break there, was able to pull down the board. Beacons are plus 7 right now on the boards against Southern Maine, as that'll be a backcourt violation unless Burston can get there first. Foot race with Flood. Flood picks it up. There was no tip by the Beacons, and it will go to the Beacons. That's turnover number 6 on Southern Maine. New 30 for the Beacons. They'll be inbounding from underneath the Southern Maine basket. Matthew finds Geary, wide open three from the corner, up and good. Grace Geary, she's been quiet today, but so good here in the second half of the year. And she's got 5, her first Maine basket of the game, shooting over 40% from behind the arc here in January. She's badgering Madden there. Now it's Romanos kicking it out up top for Madden. 3 is up, off the backboard, no good. Morrison the rebound. Madden has gone ice cold, missing her past 4 three-point attempts after knocking down the first triple of the day for either side. Southern Maine will send out Knight and Gallagher at the next whistle. Geary looking to find Morrison. Instead, she'll swing it for Matthew to Burston down low for Murphy. Murphy against Pelletier. Can't get the finish. Kicked out, and Madden gets the long rebound just inside the three-point arc. Stacy around Geary, kicks it out. Madden electing not to take the three this time around. Flood for Pelletier, immediately double teamed on the baseline. Out top for Stacy. Stacy will find Flood, who's not looking for her shot, across for Madden. Madden cross court pass for Flood, down to 6 on the shot clock. Flood has yet to look for her shot today. Stacy picks it up, back to Flood, needs to shoot the three. It's up, off the back of the rim, no good. And Matthew has the rebound, immediately looks to push. Geary will pull it out as 3 Southern Maine players back on D. Under 2 minutes to play here in the first half. The Beacons' lead is 7, their largest lead of the half. Burston to Matthew. Geary will put it up, a little bit short this time, and the rebound is in the hands of Pelletier. Got a Southern Maine timeout on the floor. Be a 30-second timeout. We'll stay here on the Beacons Broadcast Network. My name is Seth Dorensky. UMass Boston leading 23-16. Looking at some of the numbers, the Beacons shooting just 33.3%. That's the bad news. The good news, Southern Maine only shooting 29.2%. Two teams have combined for 7 turnovers apiece. Beacons, though, plus 6 on the rebounding margin at 16 defensive boards, the 13 defensive boards, and 5-2 on the offensive boards. Beacons and Southern Maine, 6 second chance points apiece. Right now it's been the Beacons swarming 2-3 defense that's causing Southern Maine some problems. Olivia Murphy has been the clear leader, 9 points and 11 boards. For Southern Maine, Megan Pelletier and Rebecca Knight have 4 points apiece to lead Southern Maine, as they've been held to just 16 points here through the first 18 minutes. They were held to 18 points on Saturday against Western Connecticut State in the second half. 3 from Stacy's up, back rim no good. Pelletier with the rebound, almost taken away by Matthew. She's double teamed. Matthew will steal it away this time. Katie Matthew showing off the quick hands, as Geary will leave it for Burston just inside the timeline. Murphy to the corner for Geary. Geary trying to find Morrison. Cross-court pass for Matthew. Morrison will move to the other block. Burst into Geary. Long three is up and good. Grace Geary. All of a sudden, she's got 7 points. Back-to-back threes for the Falmouth native, and the Beacons' lead is 10, their largest of the game. UMass Boston came in feeling very confident after their game on Sunday. Pelletier with the left hand, gets it to go off the side of the rim and in. It's a big basket for Megan Pelletier, who was just 2 of 5 in the early going. The conference's second leading scorer, Morrison up top for Burston. Her three is up and good. That's 3 threes for UMass Boston on their past 4 possessions. They're now 4 of 9 from behind the arc after starting 1 of 6. And that'll force a timeout from Courtney Mattingly, who wants to set up her defense here for the final possession. An 11-point lead. Southern Maine will have the ball with the shot clock turned off. Good news for the Beacons. They don't have to worry about foul trouble. Just 2 fouls in the half thus far. Murphy and Edwards, two players with a foul apiece. And if Mattingly really wanted to, she could play a little bit of strategy as Nelson will check back in for the Beacons during the timeout. Maybe they have a foul to give. Maybe they use it late in the game clock and try to force Southern Maine to call up another play. Southern Maine has five team fouls thus far, but that shouldn't make any kind of impact on this half unless Beacons were to get the ball back. Southern Maine will inbound from underneath their own basket. It'll be Knight into Stacy. They're out there with Gallagher, Flood, and Pelletier. Gallagher being double teamed up top. Pelletier flashed to the basket, but Knight couldn't find her. Stacy with 15 on the game clock. Over to Pelletier behind the three-point line. That's not where she's comfortable. To Stacy around the screen, trying to get it over to Pelletier. Under 10 on the clock. Pelletier over to Flood. Flood will take the long two, way off the mark, and it'll go out of bounds with a second to play in half number one. Matthew to inbound here. The Beacons will need to catch and immediately shoot. Geary calling for the ball, and she'll just hold on to it as the Beacons very happy to take an 11-point lead into the break. These teams are going in very different ways here in January. The Beacons have won five of their past six. Southern Maine lost four of six. Their only wins coming at Plymouth State, who currently sits 0-8 in conference play, and a win over Rhode Island College, who, despite their 4-3 mark in conference play, sit at just 6-11 on the season. UMass Boston with the win today, and depending what goes on in the Rhode Island College game at UMass Dartmouth, could find themselves sitting all alone in third place in the Little East Conference with six games to play. The Beacons have never hosted a Little East Conference playoff game. Could be looking pretty with six games to play. We're going to take a break and play the top 10 plays of first semester, and then we'll be back with our halftime postgame show here on the Beacons Broadcast Network. We'll have the stats, we'll have the out-of-town scoreboard, and we'll have some highlights from the men's basketball and men's hockey team, all right here on the Beacons Broadcast Network.
And welcome back to another episode of Behind the Beacon. I'm your host, Haley Dutton. It's been a wild first semester here in Beaconville, with seven teams posting winning records. With all that success, it's no surprise that the Beacons have put together some crazy plays. Here's the top 10 from first semester.
Double-double for Keeks is a distinct possibility. As we said in the pregame show, she has four double-doubles in six career games against Rhode Island. Pass from Geary. They'll swing it out to Burston, and she rattles it home off the back rim. Tajay Burston. Smith again towards the middle. Knocked up by Baker. Bumped by Glavin towards the back for Munchback. She'll get it over towards Wojewicz at the middle. Steele gets denied. Murphy wins it for the Beacons. What a block by Julia Murphy. Brittany Steele had been dominant all match long. And when it counted most, Julia Murphy was there, and UMass Boston wins a thriller.
Hanging in front, and Klutz steps in front of it. Here's a chance for Lima. She takes it and the goal! Daniel Lima! Puts the Beacons on top, 1-0. And it comes with less than 3 minutes to go in the game. UMass Boston for their first postseason victory.
Peters off time to room at the center circle. A long ball ahead for Murphy. It just stays in bounds. The Beacons are in business, and he's good to go. Murphy, far side end line. Pass up ahead, goes to the back of the net. She was looking for Pugliese over there, post, and she beats the goaltender. Erica Murphy has given the Beacons a 3-2 lead with 10 minutes to play.
one of the nicest guys on the team, an honor roll student, as that shot doesn't get through. Mike Kuhn able to knock it down. Pass in front, and it's Steven Vuko one-on-one with the goalie. Vuko shot, score! Steven Vuko, the senior out of North Providence, Rhode Island, and all of a sudden the Beacons take a 1-0 lead at 19-12.
I mean, Seth, that's the one guy, if you're Castleton, you don't want coming in on a breakaway. Steven Vuko has a lightning release.
Eventually get it. Goes one-on-one with McGuire. Double team help from Young. Gets a hand in there. Frees it up for his deal. This is Medina all the way up. Alley-oop finished by Joseph. He's flying high today, folks. Lizzie Avison. Avison shot knocked down in front. And it looked like Gare had a chance to turn it up towards the offensive end, but she loses the puck. This is Sullivan. Look at the moves. Backhanded shot. What a beauty. Alyssa Sullivan weaving magic in the offensive end. It's a 3-0 Beacon lead.
Wow. Wow. What a play by Sullivan there. Oh.
The ball. Looks to drive on Agnor. Swings it out. Big block there by Gregory Young. He'll look to take it the other way. Young puts it up with the right hand and down. And the Beacons fans go crazy as that'll force the first time out. Young swatted the shot from Brandon Barboza and then a huge dunk.
Being open all game long, and she hit four posts as well. Here she comes again, looping behind the defender. Layden pokes it on, and it's into the back of the net. 100 career goals for Krista Layden. Comes just 7 minutes in.
Expecting to be out. All right, time for Tuesday's top plays. UMass Boston women's soccer, but you can probably figure that out. Krista Layden heads the ball forward in between two defenders, chips the ball over the goalkeeper for the goal. She becomes the 30th player in.
That championship goal. Silvera has one today. Silvera bending ball, backside shot, score! Score! It's a Nelson Barros! The Beacons are champions! For the first time in men's soccer program history, Douglas Silvera the pass, and Milson Barros the goal. And the Beacons are going dancing for the first time in program history.
Which one was your favorite? From all of us here at Beacons Athletics, we wish you happy holidays. And don't forget to check out the BeaconsAthletics.com website later in December for the top 10 moments of 2014.
That was Haley Dutton bringing you the top 10 plays of first semester, and Grace gearing this Beacons women's basketball team trying to add a couple more big highlights for second semester as we check out the team statistics from that first half. The Beacons, the better end of most of the categories, 22 rebounds to 17 for Southern Maine, a 10-6 advantage in assists. The Beacons had 5 turnovers in the first 3 minutes, finished with just 7 for the half. Southern Maine with 8. Beacons shooting a little bit better than Southern Maine at 36.7%. Southern Maine at 28.6%. The big difference has been from behind the arc, though. That's why the Beacons hold this 11-point advantage. UMass Boston hitting their last 3 threes of the half, 2 from Grace Geary, who's 2 of 4 from behind the arc, and Tajay Burstyn hit her first field goal of the game. The Beacons 4 of 9. Southern Maine 2 of 13. Jill Madden hit her first. She's 1 of 4. Gretchen Anderson 0 for 2. Nicolette Kapathanasis 0 for 2. Stephanie Gallagher 0 for 2 as well. Southern Maine is going to get back into this game. They're going to need to start hitting some of their threes or change their strategy. They're giving up some size down low. Haven't been able to deal with the Beacons' bigs. Let's check out the team leaders and Olivia Murphy. Well, she's been as good as advertised. 9 points, 11 rebounds, just shy of her 35th career double-double. Megan Pelletier, she's got 6 points to lead all Southern Maine players. Also has a team-high 4 rebounds, tied with Jill Madden. Grace Geary hasn't been as good offensively as she normally is, but does lead the team with her 3 assists to go along with her 8 points, second best on the Beacons squad. The Beacons with 3 blocks in the half, 1 from Murphy, 1 from Nelson, and 1 from Katrina Edwards. For Southern Maine, Pelletier leads the team in points, rebounds, and assists. Taylor Flood with 2 steals, and Ella Romanos, the lone block in the half for Southern Maine. The Beacons have led almost the entire way. So we've had 2 ties, And right now, the Beacons with their largest lead of the game at 29-18. We'll play the highlights from the men's basketball team as they'll be on starting around 7:30 to take on the winless Southern Maine team, at least in terms of conference play. 3-14 overall, 0-7 in conference action. UMass Boston coming off a huge win over Keene State, their largest win ever against the Owls in over 50 all-time matchups. They picked up a 96-72 victory on Sunday. That victory snapped a four-game losing streak for the men's basketball team. 29-18 advantage for the women's team here at home as they look to earn their second straight conference win, move to 5-3 potentially in conference play. As let's check out right now around Beaconville, it's going to be a busy weekend outside of the Clark as a lot of Beacons teams in action, just not necessarily playing here at home. Men's basketball team, they'll play their home game tonight at 7:30. The women's hockey team hosts Manhattanville College tomorrow at 3 p.m. You can check that game out on the Beacons Broadcast Network. Then they travel to number 3, Norwich, on Saturday. The men's hockey team ranked 9/10 in the country. They travel to Skidmore College tomorrow night at 7, then a 4 p.m. game at Castleton State on Saturday. The men's hockey team coming off a huge victory over Babson. We'll show you the highlights for that one in a second, but first let's look at the Little East Conference out-of-town scoreboard. This game would be a bit of a shock just because of the 0-60 all-time mark. The Eastern Connecticut State game, though, that could be a big surprise. See, Keene State defeated Plymouth State last night 77-40 in the only game that was played on Wednesday night, as the two New Hampshire teams elected to play their game one day after the blizzard rather than two. Western Connecticut State leads Eastern Connecticut State 24-18 at the break. Western Connecticut State looked really bad for a two-week period, coming off a huge win at Southern Maine, in which they blew out the Huskies. And now they're leading Eastern Connecticut State just a game behind UMass Dartmouth in second place. That game a 24-18 advantage. Western Connecticut State 3-4 in conference action. Eastern at 5-2. The final game, UMass Dartmouth, the conference leaders, well, they're having very little problems with Rhode Island College, up 39-26. If these results were to stand, the Beacons would be sitting tied for second place in the conference at 5-3. Still a lot of time to go, 20 minutes left on the clock, and we will take a 60-second commercial break, and then we'll be back with the second half here on the Beacons Broadcast Network.
Jake. As usual, she wins it. A chance in front. Her shot is into net. Crystal landed. Yet another goal.
Please make a gift to the Beacon Athletic Fund today. We want you on our team.
Paris changed my life, and I got there through UMass. Those very specific seminal moments in Paris. The subway. A man in a tuxedo walked in, and a woman in a long gown. And it was stunning. It all hit me. It was like a lightning bolt. There was this world of beauty and style that I wanted to be a part of. That was the beginning of the journey. And that all came through the University of Massachusetts. And that was really a key moment for me. That's one of those moments you never forget.
Southern Maine ball out of halftime as they go from left to right here in the second half. Romanos will inbound to Gallagher. They also have Flood, Knight, and Pelletier out there. Three seniors and two juniors looking to stay unbeaten against UMass Boston all time. The Beacons in their 2-3 defense going with the same starting five. Murphy, Morrison, and Nelson down low from left to right. Up top it's Geary and Burston. Kick out to Flood. Three is up, way off the mark. Burston with the rebound. Southern Maine couldn't find the distance in the first half, and they are now 2 of 14 for the game. Geary looking for Morrison. Tight angle, can't find Morrison that time as Knight comes away with the rebound. Southern Maine on the year, fourth in the conference from behind the arc at 30%, shooting closer to 10% here. Flood passes up the open three. Romanos down low for Pelletier, and we'll have a hand check foul there. It'll be Morrison's first. The Beacons first here in half number two as Gary Fifield was a little bit late out on the court. He is clearly frustrated with his team's performance. Romanos in the corner. She's not a three-point shooter. Pelletier swinging it over to Gallagher. Beacons 2-3 defense has done a nice job, and with Southern Maine struggling so much from distance, as Morrison puts the hand in there, and she'll be called for her second foul in as many possessions. Second foul actually of this possession. Just 56 seconds in. The good news, Morrison had zero fouls in the first half, so Beacons now have four fouls for the game. They have some fouls to give. See if they try to go down low to Pelletier once again. Gallagher over to Knight. Knight looking for Pelletier. Morrison giving her a bit more space. The lefty up and under is no good. Morrison with the rebound. Now has 4 points and five rebounds for UMass Boston. She's the team's third leading scorer and second leading rebounder. Former Little East Conference Rookie of the Year. Geary up top for Burston. She'll look for another. Rims in and out. Morrison had the rebound in her hands. Popped out. She had a player on her back. Gallagher no look pass to Knight. Knight wide open Romanos. Morrison gets there. Off the side of the rim, no good. Murphy brushes off Pelletier. And the Beacons will look to extend this 11-point advantage. The two teams were scoreless. First 2.5 minutes of half number one. Scoreless here in the opening 1:49. Geary up top, looking to make a move. And we're gonna have an offensive foul against Murphy. Moving screen there. That's her second foul, so all of a sudden. Beacons have Three fouls here to start the second half, one more than they had in half number one. And there's two fouls apiece on Morrison and Murphy as Morrison doing battle on the block with Pelletier. Pelletier, a nice seal off, catches it just off the block. Double team comes from Nelson, out of bounds off of Pelletier, who was knocked to the ground. It wasn't enough for a foul. Southern Maine has just 2 points over the past 5 minutes of game action. It's a 13-11 game. Since then, UMass Boston has outscored Southern Maine 16-7. Beacons have led almost the entire way. Southern Maine tied it up on two occasions. They've yet to lead. Bursting over to Nelson. To Geary, and she's called for the travel. A little bit too much hesitation there. Gallagher bringing it up, one of the senior captains on this team. Southern Maine finished second in the conference a year ago, found the conference championship game to number one seed Rhode Island College. Romanoff's too strong. Rebound tapped out, and Burston will track it down. Fell in the championship game 2 years ago. They won the conference regular season and tournament title before losing to Smith College in the first round of the NCAA tournament. This senior class looking to make something happen here in the second half of the season. Nelson, front rim, no good. Morrison battling inside with Pelletier, and she'll head to the line for two. That was a ton of contact right at the rim. And Morrison will head to the line for the first time. The Beacons, with all five free throw attempts that came in the first half, they went 3 of 5 as Morrison's first is off the front of the rim, no good. Morrison, the 1,000-point scorer, just the seventh in program history, 60.8% free throw shooter. She earned six all-conference honors thus far in her career, 4 as a volleyball player in 4 years, and 2 thus far on the women's basketball circuit. Gallagher picks up her dribble 25 feet away from the basket. Flood kicks it out for Knight, long two. Thought about it, will pass up the shot with 10 seconds on the clock. Flood over Morrison, well short, off of Murphy, out of bounds, and it'll stay with the Huskies with 7 seconds to go on the shot clock. 16:33 to go. Neither team has scored here in half number two. Not the start that Southern Maine wants, as Pelletier goes hard into Morrison. More contact, no call. And Southern Maine will have 1 second left on the shot clock. They can make a catch, but they need an immediate shot, or they need to pass it to someone in the air who gets the shot off. Gallagher will be the passer. She's not guarded as Burston tries to avoid any layups. Passes into Knight, throws it off the side of the backboard. And the Beacons get the shot clock violation. The 10th turnover on Southern Maine, their second of the half. And this slow start, this scoreless start to the half is just fine for the Beacons. Geary will throw up a three, side of the rim, no good. Flood with the rebound. Courtney Mattingly not so happy with that one. She thought that Geary forced it a bit with so much time left on the shot clock. Knight cross court pass to Gallagher. Three is up, side of the rim, no good. Murphy has the rebound, had the leaker that time, as Murphy was, rather Geary was wide open in the front court. Couldn't find her. Beacons trying to get the ball inside to their two bigs. Morrison free throw line jumper, high arc, front rim, no good. Gallagher with the rebound. This has been a defensive battle, but it's also been a poor shooting display, as Geary is called for putting the hand in there, trying to swipe the ball away from Romanos. And we'll see Mallory Nelson head to the bench. And Kirsten Morrison will as well. Katrina Edwards and Katie Matthew checking in for the Beacons. UMass Boston used a 7-player rotation against Keene State, earned a 19-point victory, hoping to do the same here against Southern Maine, as they've only played 7 players. Romanos dropped the inbounds pass but got it back. Pelletier up top. Southern Maine looking to get something going after having a shot clock violation. Geary taps it away. Gets it back from Matthew. Geary running 3v3. Matthew off the glass, bounces it off the front of the rim and in. And the Beacons have the first points of half number two to extend their lead out to 13, the largest of the game. Flood finds Romanos just short of the elbow. Murphy, the huge rejection. Geary's going to look to run. The Beacons have numbers. 3-on-2. Geary to Matthew. Matthew has to pull it up. Too strong for Edwards and Burstyn. A nice job of scampering over and picking it up just short of the half-court line. 17 left on the shot clock. The Beacons will throw it over to Geary. And she rims in a three. Grace Geary with her third triple of the game. She's got 11 to lead all players. And UMass Boston has a 16-point advantage with 14:42 to play. Burstyn nearly comes up with the steal, read it perfectly, and Gary Fifield will call a timeout as his team has gone ice cold over the past three halves of basketball. Just 18 points against Western Connecticut State in the second half of their game on Saturday. 18 points in the first half. They're scoreless here over the first 5:22. We'll head to a break.
We're here at the police station for giving back to the community, having fun at the Halloween haunted house.
We decorate all the cells, create a haunted house for the kids, and by 9 o'clock tonight, it's back to our actual prison cell again. We reached out to our community groups, the local colleges, UMass. They love to work with us. We have a great relationship with UMass, so it was incredible to have the kids and the students come in and help us scare the children.
Halloween is just such a great time of year, and it's great to see all the kids having fun and helping them out.
I'd definitely be back for next year.
See the Southern Maine bench right there, now the UMass Boston bench. Gary Fifield looking for answers. His team in danger of suffering their sixth 10-loss season in the program's 55-year history. It's a program that started all the way back in 1924. Now, they didn't play from 1927 to 1967, but still would be a surprising year for a team that brought back six players from last year's team, has a lot of talent, just haven't been able to put much together over the past month. They've really struggled since the break. Geary badgering Gallagher over to Flood tonight. Back out top for Gallagher, finds Flood, who's not looking for a shot, really a bit of a liability on the offensive end is Pelletier. A nice play to get around Murphy and an N1. First points of the half for Southern Maine, as that's the third foul on Olivia Murphy. That's not good news for the Beacons. Morrison will immediately check in. Just the one free throw here for Pelletier. Pelletier, a 71.4% free throw shooter, third on the team, 11th in the conference. This is the first free throw attempt of the game for Southern Maine. UMass Boston already 7 attempts, shooting just 3 of 7, though, after they attempted a season-high 32. And Southern Maine, we talked about in the pregame, they're a team that can definitely put some full-court pressure on you. And after the made free throw, they'll go into a full-court press, something the Beacons have struggled against at points this year. Edwards over to Matthew. Matthew around a player at the elbow, and she'll draw the foul against Gretchen Anderson, who's seeing her first action here in the second half. For the Beacons, it's Morrison, Geary, Matthew, Burstyn, and Edwards. For Southern Maine, Pelletier, Gallagher, Flood, Anderson, and Knight. So one substitute in for Southern Maine, two for the Beacons, as we're going to have some conversation between one of the referees and Courtney Mattingly after he went over and talked to Gary Fifield. Geary has a wide open three. She'll take it. Nothing but net. Give her four threes on the night, and the Beacons' lead is a game-high 16. Grace Geary now has 14 points on 4 of 10 shooting. She looks to lead the Beacons in scoring for a sixth consecutive game. Knight working against Morrison. Great spin move. Up and under with the right hand. Can't get the finish. Edwards rips down another rebound. Katrina Edwards, her second rebound of the game in limited minutes. Can't give Grace Geary that much space. She was left wide open as Geary tries to force the pass in for Morrison, and Pelletier, who was fronting the Beacons center, easily came up with a steal. Nice double team from Anderson as Pelletier now on the other end around Morrison, draws the foul, and that's three fouls apiece now on Morrison and Murphy with 13:12 to go. Decision time for Courtney Mattingly. She hasn't gone into her bench for a fourth big over the past two games, and now she will. Brittany Moore, the senior co-captain out of Billerica, Massachusetts, four-year player for the Beacons, will see her first action in the past two games as Pelletier's first free throw is up and good. Pelletier now has 10 points, second player in double digits behind Geary. For Southern Maine, they bring back Kayla Stacy and Jill Madden, who both saw extended periods of time in the first half. Moore appearing in just her 14th game of the season. Pelletier too strong there, and Moore immediately a rebound. Stands at 5'11", averaging 2.5 points and 2.1 rebounds in 9 minutes a game. Burst in the high, arcing three off the backboard and no good. Rebound into the hands of Stacy. Stacy always looks to push, brought some energy to this Southern Maine team. Knight the fadeaway, can't get it to go. Matthew the rebound, and the Beacons will slow it down here with 12:45 to play. So UMass Boston out there with Edwards and Moore. These two don't see a ton of time together. The Beacons love to keep Murphy or Marson on the floor. Both of those players with three fouls got an offensive foul as the Beacons tried to have a pick at the top of the key. And it'll be Katrina Edwards picking up her second. So now the Beacons with three players with multiple fouls. All of those players are forwards for UMass Boston. The only other player to have a foul is Grace Geary with one. Beacons now with seven team fouls already. Southern Maine with just two, so the Huskies will have a chance to get some free points from the free throw line the rest of the way. Great pass down low for Pelletier. Draws the foul and one. Matthew was underneath there, giving up a ton of size, and Pelletier able to take advantage. First on Matthew, eighth on the team. And Megan Pelletier will head to the line for her fourth free throw attempt. She's 2 of 3 thus far, 12 points. And junior out of Winslow, Maine, trying to will her team back into it. Cuts the deficit down to 12 with 12:22 to play. Southern Maine, after the made free throw, will once again go into the full court pressure. Edwards takes it away from Burston, and now Southern Maine will back it off. It's a trying time for the Beacons. Really only have the one big-time scorer out there, Geary, and we'll have a moving screen there on Pelletier, who was trying to hedge off Geary. Third foul on Pelletier, so now Gary Fifield has to think about it. He's going to keep her out there, at least for the moment. Pelletier's been his only scorer here in the second half. She's got all seven of the team's points. Geary with Edwards trying to give her a screen. Geary all the way to the hoop, spins it in with the right hand. Just enough spin on that one. And the lead is back to 14. Grace Geary has 16 points. 14 of them have come over the last 9 minutes of play. Three in and out from Madden. Fighting for the rebound is Matthew. Moore to the floor, can't get it. And it's an easy bucket for Gretchen Anderson after Katie Stacy threw herself on top of the ball, took it away from Brittany Moore. This game is far from over, folks. Southern Maine has shown time and time again that they know how to finish. Stacy across for Madden. Madden, 1 of 5 from the three-point line. Made her first, has missed everyone since. Wide open three, it's up, and this one falls. All of a sudden, the Beacons' 16-point lead has been cut to 9, and the UMass Boston Beacons will call a timeout here with 11:02 to play. Murphy and Morrison to the bench, and Southern Maine starting to heat up from three. We'll take a break as the Beacons try to figure out how to slow down this Southern Maine team.
Division III allows you to give yourself to other things.
Having that free time allows me to pursue the things that I want to pursue.
Division III athletics affords students the opportunity to, you know, engage in the other interests in their campus and in their lives outside of that sport. It allows you to just be able to do everything you want to do. I wouldn't change it for the world.
Despite just 7 fouls in the first half, we've got some serious foul trouble here in half number 2. Olivia Murphy and Kirsten Morrison have 3 fouls apiece for the Beacons. Megan Pelletier has 3 fouls for Southern Maine. And the player who sparked Southern Maine back into this one heads to the bench after that big three from Jill Madden cut it to 9. For the Beacons, it's Burston, Matthew Geary, who has the ball right now, Moore and Edwards. Southern Maine, Madden, Stacy, Knight, Anderson, and just into the game for the first time, Cassidy Grover in there for Pelletier. 7 on the shot clock. Burston looks to go to work. Left-hand lay-in, no good. Rebound loose. Edwards tracks down the long rebound, and the Beacons will reset. Grover, the freshman out of Gray, Maine, listed at 5'10", making just her 7th appearance of the year, 33 minutes, 4 points, and 8 rebounds. Matthew up top with 20 on the shot clock. Burston looks to drive baseline and draws the foul on Madden, and the Beacons will get a new shot clock. Huge rebound there by Katrina Edwards after Tajay Burston was forced to go to the hoop with under 10 on the shot clock. Beacons able to kill some clock right now without their big two players down low. As that foul, the second on Madden, just the 4th overall on Southern Maine. Matthew looks to drive this time on Anderson, kicks it out for Geary. Geary with 18 on the shot clock, working one-on-one with Stacy all the way to the hoop, stripped away by Stacy. Chance the other way for Knight. Knight running with Madden. Madden will pull it out, and Stacy has it. Stacy with Geary, close to her as she'll get it off for Madden. Down low, great pass from Grover for Knight. Knight overbursting and gets the fall, and all of a sudden it's a 7-point game. Murphy will check back in for the Beacons as Courtney Mattingly watching this game slowly slip away potentially. Still a 7-point advantage after the Beacons took their largest lead of the game at 16. Burston calls her own number, driving baseline, finds Matthew, kicks it to Geary. Geary thought about the three, instead all the way to the hoop, draws the foul on the reach in on Anderson, and it will be on the floor. So second foul on Gretchen Anderson. 5th on Southern Maine. Now the Beacons will bring in Olivia Murphy. So UMass Boston now with 2 big-time scorers out there with Murphy and Geary. That should help a little bit with the scoring load. Talked about needing balanced scoring. UMass Boston's really relied on Geary and Murphy thus far. Moore up top, over to Matthew. Gives a screen for Matthew, down to 18 on the shot clock. Geary looking to get something going. Geary gets the screen from Moore. Moore will take the top of the key jumper off the side of the rim, no good. And the rebound into the hands of Grover. A couple of empty possessions for UMass Boston. And now Morrison will check back into the game with her 3 fouls. Pass down low, in and out of the hands of Grover. And the second dribble off the baseline. So Pelletier and Morrison back out there. Moore to the bench. And Grover will head to the bench on her respective side. And now Romanos will check back in. So all 4 of the starting bigs back in for their respective teams. 3 of those players with 3 fouls as Rebecca Knight will take a seat. UMass Boston could sorely use a basket. They were playing so well until Murphy picked up her 3rd foul as UMass Boston hasn't scored in the past 3 minutes. Matthew from 3, too short. Morrison kicks it off of Stacy, and they're going to say it's off of Stacy as Morrison ran the baseline, tapped it off of Stacy and went off of Morrison, but the referee ruled that it had touched Stacy first. Stacy had already been established out of bounds, and that's a big play from the Beacon senior co-captain. Matthew, cross-court pass for Geary. Morrison posting up against Pelletier. Murphy wants it at the elbow. She gets it. Spin move all the way to the hoop, too strong. Morrison can't grab the rebound, and it's all the way out to Stacy at the free throw line. Stacy looking to push. Geary tries to cut her off. Stacy has to pick up the dribble. Over to Anderson. To Pelletier on the baseline. Tries to find Romanos. Romanos gets inside of Murphy. And it's now a 5-point game. The Beacons lead was 39-25 when this streak started. It's a 9-0 run for Southern Maine. 8:07 to go as UMass Boston looks for their first ever win over the Huskies. Murphy, another spin move, gets it to go. Elbow jumper there, and that was a big one. As she pump faked and was able to hit the jumper. She's got 11. Those are her first 2 points of half number 2. Gallagher had the 3. Now Stacy will take it. Too strong. Rebound loose. Murphy fighting for it amongst 2 players. tries to get it out for Burstyn, stolen away by Stacy, and Southern Maine right now is causing the Beacons to make some mental mistakes. Gallagher up top for Stacy. Stacy 25 feet away from the basket. 15 on the shot clock. Gallagher looking to get around Geary. She taps it away. Ball's loose. Gallagher to the floor. Anderson, baseline jumper. She rims it in. Big answer for Southern Maine after the Beacons came down with the rebound, but turned it over right away. Geary looking down low for Murphy. Spins, left hand laying. No good, but she'll draw the foul. It'll be Pelletier's fourth foul. Sixth foul on Southern Maine. And if Gary Fifield had decisions to make on the third foul, he's really got a tough spot here. Megan Pelletier, his top scorer. She's got 13 points on 5 of 10 shooting, and she'll head to the bench. Rebecca Knight back in there. How long can you keep Pelletier on the bench? She's been the team's best player today. Murphy gets the first free throw to fall. She's got 12 points now, just 2 of 4 from the line. The Beacons shooting 50% from the free throw line at 4 of 8. Her free throw shooting cost them against UMass Dartmouth. They shot just 7 of 17, but Murphy too short on the first one. UMass Boston would love to not have this game end up as a free throw shooting battle. Knight from the elbow over to Gallagher, passes up the 3, finds Romanos. Romanos finds a cutting Knight. Knight leaves it off for Gallagher, 6-footer, and it falls. So the Beacons get 1 point, Southern Maine answers with 2, and the deficit's the shortest it's been since late in the first half at 4 points. 6:35 to go. Last year, UMass Boston fell by a single point. A missed free throw from Andrea Suffredini with a second to go. As Morrison draws the foul on Romanos, all of a sudden the Beacons now will be shooting the 1-1. For Romanos, that's her second, team 7th. And these are some big free throws for Kirsten Morrison. 0-for-2 from the line, 60.8% shooter. Beacons could go a long way towards wrapping up this game if they can hit some free throws. Morrison, too strong, rebound loose over Matthew and into the hands of Anderson. Southern Maine has never led in this game. The Beacons led by as many as 16 points before a 9-0 run, and Southern Maine has kept their momentum going. Stacy, the long three, it's up, too strong, long rebound out. Murphy with another one, she's got a double-double. And Matthew will slow it down. The Beacons with their starting 5 out there. Only played a 7-man rotation on Sunday. They've gone as deep as 8 today. This group has to be a little bit tired, but those 2 extra days in between games definitely helped. Murphy from the top of the key over to Geary. 7 on the shot clock. Geary looking to give it back to Murphy. She'll drive herself, and we've got a hand check foul there. It's going to be on Gallagher. Gallagher second, team's 8th, and now Grace Geary, second on the Beacons in free throw shooting this season. We'll head to the line for 2. Hits the first one. She's 3 of 3 from the line. 81.5% from the line. Good for 4th best in the Little East Conference amongst players who qualify. She hits the second one as well, looking so confident in her 4 free throws today. Geary's now hit 4 on 4 attempts. The rest of the Beacons are just 2 of 8. Corner 3 for Anderson, well off the mark, too strong. Matthew with the rebound, immediately outlets it to Geary, but Geary will slow it down. And Courtney Mattingly smiles on that one. Murphy, triple team, throws it up nonetheless, too strong. Murphy tried to get a tie up there. Rebecca Knight nearly traveled, but no call from the referee. Stacy working against Burstyn. Romanos finds a cutting Knight. Knight will put it up, stripped. And it's off of Rebecca Knight, and Gary Fifield can't believe it. Interesting sequence of events. The Beacons thought that Knight traveled after Murphy was providing some pressure, and then Knight thought it went off of Matthew. Either way, the Beacons have the ball with 5 minutes to play. Geary with her back to the basket, just behind the 3-point line, getting some pressure from Romanos. Swings it around for Matthew, can't make the catch. Anderson slow to pick it up. Ahead for Stacy. Burstyn gets a hand in and will get the ball right back. Neither team could really control possession there as Geary tried a backhand pass to Matthew when she was double-teamed, and that led to a series of sloppy plays. Morrison has it stripped by Romanos as she tried to get around her. Pass ahead from Gallagher to Anderson. Anderson all the way to the hoop, through the double-team, and we've got ourselves a four-point game. Geary will come all the way over the bench, and we'll get a timeout. 4:15 to play. UMass Boston's led by as much as 16, looking to hold on here and earn their first ever victory against Southern Maine in 61 all-time meetings. Take a timeout along with the teams as the Beacons look to make a statement here in the Little East.
What separates UMass Boston from other schools is the fact that a large percentage of students commute. For me, it takes 2 hours each day to go to and from school, but every second has been worth it because the students that come here are serious about learning, they value their education, and understand where it'll take them in the future. This is what UMass Boston means to me.
Here's what we've got going on for you here at the Clark Athletic Center. A four-point Beacons lead, 18 fouls apiece. Foul trouble for Southern Maine, really only one player. It's Megan Pelletier, has four fouls. She's checking back in here in the timeout for the Beacons. Murphy and Morrison have three fouls apiece. It's the Beacons ball out of the timeout. UMass Boston led 39-25. Since then, it's a 15-5 run. Cut this to a four-point game. Southern Maine hasn't been any closer than four here in the second half, and they have not led at all. Geary all the way to the hoop. Scoop shot. Can't get it to go. Murphy nearly had the rebound. It's Knight pulling it down and immediately gets it out to Stacy. Stacy looking to push over to Gallagher. Gallagher down low for Pelletier. Pelletier double-teamed. Was looking for Knight. Crosses it over into the corner for Anderson. At the elbow, it is Rebecca Knight. Swings it for Gallagher. Three is up, and it goes! Stephanie Gallagher playing in her 101st career game, and that's a big one from the senior tri-captain to cut it to one. Pass down low off of Murphy's hands. Had a chance to go, but a little bit too strong. And now Southern Maine a chance for their first lead of the contest. Stacy picks up her dribble, gets it over to Knight. Knight down low for Pelletier. Great position and over Matthew to give Southern Maine a one-point advantage. Talked about, don't be intimidated. This is the point that you can really show what you're made of. The Beacons led by as many as 16. They've struggled, and now Gallagher called for the hand check, her second foul on that exact transgression over the past couple minutes. And Grace Geary talked about it, fourth best in the conference in free throw shooting at over 80%. She's 4 of 4 thus far, as a chance to give the Beacons the lead right back. Too short on the first front end of the 1-1. The final 1-1 the Beacons will have, and now it's a chance for Southern Maine to extend that lead. Gallagher just hit her first three of the game tonight. Knight will swing it wide open, three for Stacy. Too strong, rebound loose. Matthew fighting for it, can't pull it down, and Anderson gets her paws on it. 25 on the shot clock, 2:45 to go in the game. The Beacons facing their first deficit of the week. Anderson all the way. Too short, rebound poked loose, and Pelletier comes down with the big board. Megan Pelletier, her fifth rebound of the game, came in averaging close to 9. Anderson all the way, pulls it up. Stacy has it, and we've got a 3-second call on Anderson there. As Anderson picked up her dribble and then stayed there. The first 3-second call of the night. Under 2:30 to play, the Beacons trying to take the lead back. Have not shot well here in the second half. Bursting. Looking for a player down low. Murphy. Entry pass kicked out to Matthew. Three is up. Off the back of the rim. No good. Long rebound into the hands of Stacy. Pelletier kicks it. Stacy looking for a triple. Too strong. Rebound loose. Bursting fighting for it. And we've got a push on Rebecca Knight against the smaller and slightly faster Tajay Burston, and the Beacons' best statistical free throw shooter will head to the line. Tajay Burston, the sophomore point guard out of Springfield, Massachusetts, 81.8% from the free throw line. Has limited attempts this year, so she hasn't qualified for the league leaders, but so smooth from the free throw line, she'll have two, as that was the 10th foul on Southern Maine. Burstyn's first, back rim no good. The Beacons now miss back-to-back free throws, 6 of 14 for the game. Southern Maine 3 of 4 on the other side. This could easily be a two-possession game if the Beacons have just done a better job from the free throw line. Burstyn, though, hits the second, and we're all even at 45. Remember, last year it was a missed free throw with 1 second to go that hurt the Beacons as they fell by a single point to Southern Maine. A 47-46 loss. Strong move from Knight all the way to the tin, and she gets it to go with the left hand. This is the biggest lead Southern Maine has had today at 2 with 90 seconds to play. Southern Maine and a man-to-man. Matthew looking for Morrison down low. Up top for Murphy. Murphy looks to take it all the way. Too strong off the glass. Rebound kicks out to Geary. Geary with 11 seconds left on the shot clock. Ball never hit the rim. Geary realizing it. Fakes it down low for Murphy. Draws the foul. And she'll go to line for two on the block there from Stacy. For Stacy, that's her first foul. But Southern Maine already has 10-plus fouls, and Olivia Murphy will head to the line for two. 70% free throw shooter. She's just 2 of 5 from the line. Murphy taking her time this time around. First free throw is up. Nothing but net. And now the Beacons are going with a bit of defense for offense here during the stoppage as Mallory Nelson will check in for Katie Matthew. Murphy's second is good as well. 67 seconds to play. The game is tied at 47. Could this be a race to 50? Gary Fifield will call the timeout. 101 to play, 25 seconds on the shot clock. We'll take a break along with the teams. Both teams looking at potentially just one last possession to determine the winner of this big Little East Conference matchup.
The University of Massachusetts Boston. It's just minutes from downtown, and the Princeton Review calls it one of the best values in the country. A nationally recognized institution of academic excellence and research, UMass Boston offers more than 150 undergraduate and graduate programs, 16 Division III sports, and more than 100 student organizations. To learn more about the opportunities waiting for you at UMass Boston, visit in person or online. UMass Boston, a research university with a teaching soul.
Southern Maine huddling up around Gary Fifield. It's already been a historic year for Southern Maine, maybe for some of the wrong reasons. Already in conference play, they dropped their first ever game to UMass Dartmouth up in Gorham. As the Corsairs, the other Little East Conference team out of Massachusetts, earned a 77-68 victory back on January 10th. Beacons looking to make some history of their own against Southern Maine with their first ever victory against the Huskies. Pelletier over to Stacy. 19 on the shot clock. Stacy over to Anderson. Anderson looking to drive, pulls it up, looks for Pelletier down low against Edwards, and we've got a travel. Too many stuffs from Pelletier and the Beacons offense for defense. Edwards and Nelson checking out. Morrison and Matthew back in. Katrina Edwards did her job there, able to keep in front of Megan Pelletier, and Pelletier called for the travel with 49.2 seconds to go. Southern Maine should get it back as Burstyn will call the timeout after getting across the half-court line, and we'll stick with you this time around. For the Beacons, you know the five that are going to be out there. Morrison, Murphy, Edwards, Matthew, and Geary. It's no surprise that Grace Geary has the hot hand. She's been averaging close to 20 points per game in January. She's won 3 straight Little East Conference Rookie of the Week awards, was named to the D3Hoops.com Team of the Week a week ago. In 2 games last week, averaged 23.5 points per game. Geary, though, so dangerous when she has the ball in her hands, because if she is fouled, she'll head to the line for two free throws, 4 of 5 today from the free throw line. Looking at the other Beacons, Olivia Murphy, 14 points on the identical 5 of 12 shooting line with Geary. Morrison's been quiet, 4 points, 6 rebounds. Tajay Burstyn, 4 points on 1 of 6 shooting. And Matthew has 5 points on 2 of 8 shooting. For Southern Maine, Pelletier leads all Huskies players with 15 points and 5 rebounds. Rebecca Knight has 8 points, 5 boards, and 5 assists. Anderson has 6 points. And Romanos, who looked like she was going to check in, has 7. It will be Gallagher, Romanos, Pelletier, Stacy, and Anderson for Southern Maine. Beacons keep the same 5 out there. Matthew looking to get the ball in. She finds Geary after a 4 count. Geary working against Gallagher. Over to Matthew. Matthew down low for Murphy. She has her spot, throws it up. She's partially blocked. Anderson has it, and now Murphy is fouled. Murphy fouls her reaching in, and that'll lead to a 1-1 for Southern Maine. It's the 4th foul on Olivia Murphy, and Gretchen Anderson, who's yet to attempt a free throw today, will head to the line. 3 of 6 from the free throw line this season. She'll be shooting the 1-1. Southern Maine, 3 of 4 from the free throw line. The first player on Southern Maine to shoot a free throw other than Pelletier. Nothing but net. A huge free throw for the junior out of St. Thomas Aquinas High School. She's a transfer. Went to Allegheny College as a freshman down in Pennsylvania. Second one from Anderson. Nothing but net as well. And the Beacons down by 2 with 35.7 to go. 5-second difference between shot clock and game clock. And the Beacons will elect to call another timeout. Take a break along with the teams. 31.1 to play. UMass Boston trailing by 2. The Beacons will come out of the timeout with the same 5, as will Southern Maine. 6.1 second difference between the game clock and the shot clock. Beacons will give Southern Maine a chance late as Morrison goes all the way to the tin and it's off of Romanos. Beacons thought that was enough for a foul. Either way, it'll stay with the Beacons. 25.2 left on the clock now. Matthew inbounding from underneath the Southern Maine basket. Matthew trying to find Morrison. Comes all the way out to Stacy. The Beacons need to foul. And Burstyn will. As Matthew was trying to find Murphy. Rather, Matthew was trying to find Morrison posting up. And now another 1-1 coming for Kayla Stacy, freshman guard out of Auburn, New Hampshire. She's 4 of 8 from the free throw line this year. So Gretchen Anderson, who is a 50% free throw shooter, just hit a pair. If Stacy can hit both, she misses the first. It's a double bonus. That was the 10th foul. If she hits the second one, it'll be a 3-point game. She can't make it a 2-possession game at this point. Stacy's second one rims in, and it's a 3-point game with 24 seconds to go. The Beacons do not need a 3-pointer right now. If they are to take a 2, though, they need a quick basket. Geary around a double screen. Steps back over to Burstyn. Burstyn looking to drive. Draws the foul on Stacy, who was unhappy with herself. It's not a bad foul, though, from the freshman. 15.2 seconds to go. Burstyn can't tie it as she'll get 2 free throws. And now it comes down to which team can hit their free throws and can the Beacons force a turnover. Burstyn 1 of 2 from the line thus far. Too strong on the first. UMass Boston now 9 of 18 from the free throw line. And if they're to fall today, they can look at their production from the free throw line. Second free throw, nothing but net, and the Beacons need a turnover. Two-point game, 15.2 to go. Knight with the catch, two-on-one chance. She has Pelletier ahead, finds her, right-hand laying, and it's a four-point game. Largest lead of the game for Southern Maine with 10.9 to play. Geary looking to push. The Beacons need a three, and they need it right now. Geary will take the wide-open three. It's up front rim, no good. Rebound out to Romanos. Romanos to Gallagher, and that'll do it. Southern Maine comes back from a 16-point second-half deficit. They did not lead in the first half. They did not take their lead until the final 5 minutes of the second half. But some clutch shooting from Megan Pelletier and some clutch free throws from the combination of Gretchen Anderson and Kayla Stacy were enough as UMass Boston, their poor free throw shooting came back to bite them. The Beacons just 10 of 19 from the free throw line. And UMass Boston will have to head up to Gorham, Maine to try to come away with that first ever victory against the Huskies, as we'll bring you the final score in just a second. Tough break for UMass Boston as they fall to 11-7, 4-4 in conference play. For Southern Maine, back to 500 at 9-9, move to 5-3 in conference action. And with that victory, Southern Maine a step closer to another home playoff game. The Beacons are gonna need to rebound and rebound fast. They'll have to travel to Rhode Island College on Saturday, a team that they beat the first time around by 5 to snap a 15-game losing streak, but Southern Maine's come a long way. Rather, Rhode Island College has come a long way since that first matchup.
Beacons on the track. Beacons on the track. My name is Tyler Hart. Beacons on the track. Being on the track and field team here is the greatest decisions I've made besides coming to UMass Boston. When you train together in that sort of intensity, you build a sort of a bond with people who are training with you. You know, it's like a higher level of friendship. It's like teammates, it's just a different level. My freshman year, I got a Rookie Athlete of the Year. Outdoor for my sophomore year, I was the first time I went to Nationals. When I jump, it's a little difficult considering I have hereditary disorder known as amblyopia.
There we go.
It's pretty much just a partial blindness in the left eye. The best way to describe it is if you have decent prescriptions for contact lenses, you take one of the lenses out, and then you close you put your hand over the eye with that lens. That's my vision. I rely more on my steps as opposed to my visual perception of how far away the bar is. And since I can't see out of my left eye, I have to sit on the far left-hand side of the class. Hopefully coach for a few years, coach some high school kids, maybe even coach on a college level as like an assistant coach, and go to PA school, and then do a five-year program and try to get my loans paid back, and then go from there.
I'm Alexa Capion, I'm from Messina, New York. I'm a junior on the women's ice hockey team, and I'm an exercise health science major. But when I got here, I met Coach Harris, and I saw the facility, and I met a couple of the girls on the team, and I pretty much got a feel of the program, and I knew right away that this is where I wanted to go to school. We have all league games for the rest of the year, so that's gonna be a huge test for us. We need those points to hopefully come out with a good standing for playoffs. A couple of highlights from the last couple of years that I've been playing was probably last year when we won our first Codfish Bowl. We made history that year. I was really excited to be part of that. I don't have very many goals, but when I do score, it's definitely a big deal.
That's a goal!
For the past 3 years, we've had Emily. She is a member of the Team Impact program, and that's for children with illnesses that want to be part of a collegiate program. She's great. She comes and watches all of our games. She has her own jersey. She has her own stick. We've got her all this equipment. She's really awesome to have. She gives us a lot of motivation and she comes in the locker room and talks to us before games, and it's really cool to have her here and be part of our team. When I graduate, I definitely want to go to graduate school, most likely for either athletic training or physical therapy. Our trainers here have definitely given me an insight about what it takes to be an athletic trainer. They're always on top of everything. They always know how to help us and what to do and what not to do. They're always there for us when we need them, and that's given me a lot of help with what I could be doing after I graduate, so that's nice to have them.
I'm Elizabeth Glavin, sophomore business management major from Edina, Minnesota. I love being a part of this volleyball team. Volleyball is what brought me to UMass Boston. I looked at our recruiting website one last time and saw UMass Boston on it, came out for a visit the next week, and it kind of hit all the boxes that I was looking for. In a good city, good academic school, good volleyball program, it had everything I wanted. Although it was far away from home, I knew this is where I wanted to be. Winning six back-to-back LEC titles is really a dynasty, I think, and Terry has really focused hard on recruiting and building this dynasty and continuing to build a program that can continue to win championships, and it's really lucky to be a part of something this great. Last year, I was the Little East Conference Defensive Player of the Year, All-Conference Second Team, NCAA Regional MVP of the Regional Tournament, ABC All-Region Honorable Mention, and New England Women's Volleyball Association All-Rookie Team and Honorable Mention. I think my favorite game would have to be playing in the Regional Championship last year. We played against a really good Williams team, and I think that match, we started off a little shaky, lost the first set we've lost in the whole playoff season, and I think that kind of shook us a little bit. We came back firing, and we're ready to go those next couple games. Our coaches are bringing in a lot of really strong girls who want to make a commitment and make an impact in this program, and I think that is why we're continuing to do well and we'll continue to do well for the next few years. Being a student here has been really awesome as well. I've recently started taking more of my business classes and found that it's a good choice and a good fit for me. And eventually, I hope to open my own business and kind of be successful and do what I love at the end of the day.
UMass Boston was my first choice because when I came to the campus, I saw that there was a lot of diversity.
And welcome back to our Beacons post-game show. Southern Maine, a 52-48 winner, moving to 61-0 all-time against UMass Boston. The past five matchups have all been decided by single digits, but that's as much solace as the Beacons can take. They led almost the entire way. Southern Maine taking their first lead with under 5 minutes to play. Their largest lead was four, but the Beacons 10 of 19 from the free throw line, and that really cost them in the end. Let's check out the final statistics. Southern Maine did a great job of rebounding from that first half. Southern Maine cut it to two on the boards. They were much better in the second half as they trailed by four in assists in the first half, ended up with four more than the Beacons, and UMass Boston committing 12 turnovers in the second half. Beacons shot just 32% rather. Southern Maine went up to 35.6%. Beacons were able to lead for so long because of their three-point shooting, 35% compared to just 17.4%. But Southern Maine, a little bit too much veteran prowess as they were able to execute under the 14-time Little East Conference Coach of the Year, and it showed for Gary Fifield and his squad. Let's check out the team leaders for the two sides. Grace Geary and Olivia Murphy had big games. Geary with 18 points and a team-leading four assists. Olivia Murphy, 14 points and 16 rebounds, but it wasn't enough in a losing cause. Megan Pelletier, a huge game, 17 points, 5 rebounds. It was Kayla Stacy off the bench who had some of the biggest plays of the game, finished with a team-high 7 rebounds, hit one of two free throws to make it a three-point game on that second-to-last possession. Then Pelletier extended it out and helped her team with the win with a layup in the closing moments. Rebecca Knight, a game-high 6 assists. Check out where the Beacons will be heading next, as UMass Boston will travel to Rhode Island College on Saturday, 1 p.m. game. Then the Beacons will have their final non-conference contest of the season. That'll be Tuesday at 5:30 as they host Suffolk University, the two schools separated by just 5 miles. Normally one of the better contests of the year here in Boston. And then the Beacons will travel to Eastern Connecticut State, currently sitting in second place in the conference. That one could be a big one if the Beacons can rebound against Rhode Island College this Saturday. Like to thank our crew, doing a great job. It's the first time this crew has worked together, and they really put it all together in this, their first time. The weather taking a couple of our normal crew members out of action. Elizabeth Glavin and Bree Souza, our directors, both working for the first time, directing the TriCaster. Ryan Augustine, the steady-handed camera operator, joined by Alexander Carlos and Elisa Brooks, two new members of our crew. And my name is Seth Dorensky, providing the play-by-play. That'll do it for game number one. Southern Maine, a 52-48 victor over UMass Boston. Welcome back to the Clark Athletic Center Gymnasium for game number two of today's Little East Conference doubleheader. This one will pit the UMass Boston men's basketball team coming in at 10-8, 2-5 in conference play, looking for their first two-game Little East Conference winning streak in 2 years against the Southern Maine team, trying to avoid their second 0-14 mark in conference play in the past five seasons. Southern Maine 3-14, 0-7 thus far, the last team that remains winless in the conference after they dropped a contest last week at home against Plymouth State. Those two teams both came in at 0-5. Looking at the team statistics for today's matchup and see Southern Maine -8 in scoring margin. The Beacons, one of the top scoring teams in the conference at 77.5 points a game. UMass Boston will really look to push the pace. Southern Maine on the other side without a couple of their top players. Fred Knight, the big 6'7", 290-pound transfer out of Hampton, Maine. He is a scratch for today's contest, along with Alex Frazier, the junior guard in his first season with the University of Southern Maine. He's appeared in 11 games, so two of their better offensive players out of action. They'll go with a slightly shorter rotation, or at least with players that are a little bit less familiar to seeing time, so UMass Boston should be looking to push even more than normal. See Southern Maine, despite having two players at 6'7" or taller, just a -3.5 rebounding margin. The Beacons at 4.5, three of the top six rebounders in the conference in Carl Agnor, Carl Joseph, and Gregory Young. We'll see those three players in the team leaders. Joseph, the second leading scorer in the conference at 19.5 points per game. Carl Agnor, 10th in the nation in all of Division III with his 11.2 rebounds per game. On the other side, Jacob Littlefield is the leading scorer for Southern Maine. He had just 149 points in his first 2 years with the Huskies, already 232 this year, averaging 14.5 points per game. He's second on the team to Cole Libby with his 5.1 rebounds per game. Zach Leal, sophomore guard out of York, Maine, will come off the bench. He's been very good this year, leads the team with his 3 assists per game. Then you see Gregory Young's name. Senior transfer out of Roxbury Community College, leads the team in assists, steals, and blocks per game. He's also second on the Beacons in scoring at over 15 points per game and third on the team with just over 7 rebounds per game. We'll take a break to show you the highlights from last year's game between these two sides here in Boston. Southern Maine came in and kept the Beacons winless in conference play. It was James Odd-Neal scoring with 2.1 seconds to play to hand the Beacons a 65-63 loss.
Southern Maine 3 at the buzzer, and knocked off the defense. It's on Neal. And Neal turns his leg down to 5 seconds. Fresno looks to get it off past the players at the three-point line. And it's Joseph looking right for the long run. Look at Zubo, will throw the baseball pass towards the Beacon fans. Joseph catching it, throws it up.
Was James O'Neill, who was a junior a year ago, not on the roster this season with the big bucket over Salim Omerovich for the Beacons. Carl Joseph had that last second effort, set it just a little bit long as the Beacons completed an 0-14 campaign a year ago, already off to a much better start at 2-5. The Beacons look to send off 39th year head coach Charlie Titus with a bang in his final season as the head coach. He'll stay on here at UMass Boston as the Vice Chancellor for Athletics and Recreation. Let's take a look at the all-time series. The Beacons still trailing, not as bad as the women's series in which Southern Maine won their 61st game in 61 all-time meetings. Southern Maine has won 7 of the past 8. Last Beacons win came on February 5th of 2013. A big win here at home. Well, the Beacons have lost 2 of the past 3 games here at the Clark Athletic Center Gymnasium in really heartbreaking fashion. A 2-point loss a year ago. 3 years ago, it was a 1-point loss as Southern Maine buried a 3 at the buzzer to hand the Beacons a 1-point loss. The last time these two teams played was here at the Clark Athletic Center Gymnasium. The Beacons dropped a 2-point game. 2 years ago, they played in the Little East Conference quarterfinals, the 4-5 game. Southern Maine shot a blistering 60% to hand the Beacons an 85-65 defeat. The one player who's always really played well against Southern Maine, Carl Joseph, last year averaging 21 points per game. He's our player to watch, sixth in program history with his 1,135 career points, second in the conference in scoring, first in minutes. He's also in the top 5 in rebounds per game and blocks per game, as Carl Joseph shown right there, the senior out of Brockton, Massachusetts, an All-American in the high jump. And Carl, in his fourth year with the team, the only 4-year senior, as the Beacons do have 5 of them this season, looking to really finish off his basketball career strong. So he'll be competing for a national title this spring in the high jump. Let's take a look at the starters right now for Southern Maine. We talked about the absence of 2 of their players who have had big years under 12th year head coach Carl Henriksen. They'll have Cole Libby, the junior guard out of Buxton, Maine, former Mr. Maine basketball finalist back in 2012. The captain this year, averaging 7.7 points per game and a team best 5.8 rebounds and 2.7 assists per game, also leads the team in steals with 24. Isaiah Stone Patterson, the freshman guard out of Rockland, Maine, getting his first start of the season, averaging just 4.5 minutes per game in 14 games, said 6 points and 3 rebounds, did have a career-high 14 minutes of play in a big loss against Western Connecticut State on Saturday. Sean Cadigan, a junior guard out of Bethel, Maine, a captain and a former transfer out of the University of New England, will get the start, his 18th only player to have started all 18 games under Carl Henriksen. 7.9 points, 2.4 rebounds. He's the team's best three-point shooter, 85 three-point shots, and you know he's a spot-up shooter, just 4 free throw attempts all season long. Ben Jackson, junior center out of Houston, Texas. He's 6'8", 220 pounds, making his second start, 2.7 points per game, 2.6 rebounds per contest for the Huskies. Now let's check out the starters for UMass Boston as the Beacon starting 5 will introduce themselves.
Gregory Young, senior, small forward out of Dorchester.
Omar Benabicha, junior, shooting guard, Saugus, Mass.
Salim Omarovich, junior forward, Saugus, Massachusetts.
Luke Ulysses, senior point guard from Brooklyn, New York.
Carl Joseph, senior forward, Brockton, Massachusetts.
Southern Maine riding a 10-game losing streak